Okay, we'll quickly go over 3M here. Very household name, very blue chip, generally growing over time. Obviously, like everything, it has its peaks and valleys that can provide us investors more and or less opportunistic times to buy. Let me start marking up this chart and we'll see where we end up. This one's very parabolic. It's not necessarily following any price channels. If anything, you could draw a big Fibonacci circle on it, but I don't know if it's really necessary here. I'll just do it just for illustration's sake. But as you can see, it very much respects its moving averages. Well, something like that. Look at how perfectly the purple lines up with this run here. Lines up perfectly, breaks through, comes down, touches this bottom line on the Fibonacci, comes back up, uses its previous support, which was this purple to magenta color line as a resistance. It gets used as a resistance right here, also right here in 2015, and then it comes all the way up here. Touches the line it was actively using as a support, boom, gets used as a resistance, falls back, comes down, uses the same line as a support, comes up, attempts to break out of that same line it just used as a resistance and a support, and right now, you know, it pushed through but then kind of sold off a little bit down to the monthly 20 moving average. It's crazy. As you can see, right now, this current formation that it's at, it looks very similar to 2010, 2011. Right here, with the entry being a little something like right here. Start to see the parallels. The most ideal entry for a company like this, as you can see, even going all the way as far back as 1980, if you could buy shares at the monthly 180 moving average, that's a really solid position. It's only touched that price point 3 times since 1980, so if you were entering at that monthly 180 moving average, it would be highly likely that your position would grow and it would not touch that for a very long time. Let me quickly go over the financials. Again, this is 3M company, symbol MMM, very household name. My name's Ethan. Make sure to visit my website, ethanwrenn.com. From there, you can find links to all my various socials. We are live on 5 platforms right now, wherever you may be watching, whether it be YouTube, Twitch, Twitter, Facebook, or DLive. Make sure you're following if you want to stay up to date with all the latest information. We also have merchandise. Feel free to look at that. So with symbol 3M here, in the year 2016, they had a profit margin of 16.77%. In 2017, they had a profit margin of 15.35%. Let me mute the music real quick. 2018, they had a profit margin of 16.3%. 2019, they had a profit margin of 14.22%. And in 2020, they had a profit margin of 16.73%. Okay, so here's an example of a company that was not impacted by Corona almost at all. I mean, if you were looking at these financials, very flat. I mean, revenue has remained largely unchanged for the past 4 years. profit margins, again, in that 15 to 16% range, that is better than Dave & Buster's, which we were just looking at, which was at that 9% range, kind of on the lower side of things. 3M also offers a dividend of 3.43%. That is excellent. That is right in that U.S. national average range. Again, we always comment on the dividend, whether they have zero, whether they have like an 8% dividend. This company falls right in that U.S. national average of 3 to 4%. Perfect. If we look at earnings real quick, Q4 2020, I mean, hit. They just hit. Now, analysts are pretty soft on this company. As you can see, they've been getting softer and softer over the past year. Corona kind of makes sense. They seem to be hitting quite consistently, though. So no problems there with earnings. Here, you can see at the bottom, the dividend seems to be paid out quarterly. Also good as compared to an annual. Monthly would be the best case scenario. Current market cap, $99 billion. How do we feel about that? That's pretty massive. Teetering on that $1 trillion mark. That $1 trillion mark, kind of a mental resistance here. How far away are they from $1 trillion? Really not far. So, in early 2021. June 2021, they were 20% higher than they are now. And then in 2018, they were 50% higher than they are now. So that would definitely push them into that $1 trillion range. It's interesting that they've kind of sold off from that $1 trillion range twice now. Not ideal. And we are starting to see a little bit of a descending resistance. It has yet to reclaim its all-time highs from 2018. Sorry, wrong thing here. We have a little bit of a resistance forming. We have two prior, so this is a very legitimate resistance here. Let me expand on this. We'll go wick to wick. If you are able to get shares at around that 132 price point, that would be your ideal entry. You could put in bids there, kind of forget about it and not feel stressed. Other than that, it's really struggling to hold that monthly 20 moving average. In September, it hit it for the first time. You saw a little bit of a spin with this doji here in October. November, we saw a firm push down. A wick at the top, which means it tried to push up, failed, went right back down, closed lower. And here we are with a little bit of a December doji inches below that monthly 20 moving average. We could see it touch that monthly 180 moving average, which would be our ideal entry. How do you determine where to place the circles? If you look at the lines that are associated with said circle, I was attempting to try and talk about that earlier. Let me try and be a little more clear. Look at how closely this purple line here follows the price action and acts as a support. When I was talking about the supports and resistance and how the circle was interacting with the price, look, there's like a round bottom right here acting as a support. Here, I'll even mark it even more. I should have put some more lines down here. Support bounced here off the circle, bounced here off the circle, bounced here off the circle, bounced here off the circle. And then it was really kind of riding the circle between 1988 and 99. For 10 years, it was very much just riding it, but there was quite clearly a bounce here in 98, quite clearly a bounce here in 94, et cetera, et cetera. It's very much responding here, and we didn't see a break until right here, which would be 2007, 2008 market crash, makes sense. It was in this year, 2008, that it actually broke this purple line that it had quite clearly been acting as a support for so long, and it went below, and it came all the way down to the next line in the Fibonacci circle, uncoincidentally. From there, it went up, and it acted all the way till it hit the previous line of the Fibonacci circle that we had mentioned up till now, where it acted as a support right here in 2011. No coincidence. So it was rejected by that line, came back down, touched that 180 moving average, continued to climb, was used as a resistance again by the first Fibonacci circle line that we had mentioned prior that was acting as a support and has now acted as a resistance for the second time. Came down a little bit, continued to rise, and then touched the second Fibonacci line, which we had been referencing that acted as a support once prior. It was used as a resistance, came down, touched the second Fibonacci line we've been referencing, was used as a support, and then it kind of was flagging in that circle. Notice where the center of the circle is here. Starts at the bottom, comes all the way up to the price level of where the center of these Fibonacci circles are, and then it flags. This is a very common pattern for parabolic movements. Just something of note. That's kind of how I knew where to put the Fibonacci line. Have we talked about 3M enough here? Should we go on to the next symbol? Let's see what else I got here, unless you guys have one. Could cover LB Company. I feel like I've covered them before. Buzz, I feel like I've covered them before. They're not much to talk about. Let's open my box real quick. Unboxing, guys. You guys want to see the unboxing? Again, we've unboxed two so far. I could quickly show you guys what those are.